Last week, someone sent me a message on Instagram. They said, is it possible to do two different mixes on the M32, one for the live audience and one for broadcasting television? And I thought this was a very interesting question, so I told that person how to do it. But I'm also making a video about it because at some point in the future, if you work in live sound, you might be asked to do this. And yes, you can send the main left-right that you're mixing live also to the broadcast, but in most cases, no matter how good the main mix is, it's not appropriate for broadcasting. It's not what people expect to hear. And also, why am I making a video if you can use mix buses, right? You have 16 mix buses, so you can do 16 mixes, 16 different mixes, right? Wrong. The mix buses only allow you to change the levels of the channels, but you cannot change the EQ, you cannot change the compression, you cannot change the effects. What I'm talking about right here is doing two completely different independent mixes with different EQ, different effects, different compression, different everything. And ideally, you're gonna need to bring another person to do the broadcast mix because yes, you can do all of it yourself if you want, but it's gonna be really difficult to be able to hear what's going on with the other mix if you are in the live room mixing the live mix. And you also need to focus on your live mix. So get another person, give them an iPad or a computer, let them connect to the control app of the mixer so both of you are using the same mixer, but one of you is on the board, the other is on the app, and the person on the app should be in a quieter place or in a different room even to be able to hear what's going on with the other mix. And this video is a bit of an advanced tutorial, okay, so I'm not gonna be explaining everything in detail. I'm gonna assume that the basic, more trivial concepts, you know how to do them. The first and biggest compromise you have to accept is the number of channels. The mixer has 32 channels and it's designed to do one main mix. If you want two main mixes, you can only use half of the channels, so 16 channels for each mix. The difference between a subgroup and a post-fader bus, they are basically the same, but a subgroup, you mix the channels with the actual faders. On a post-fader bus, you mix them with the sends. So it makes more sense for this case to use a subgroup for the second mix. Let's get into it. I'm gonna go to routing and I'm gonna give channels 17 to 32 the same inputs as 1 to 16. So I'm gonna select 1 to 8, 9 to 16. And now because these channels and these channels are having the same inputs, it means that if I change the gain on channel number 17, it will also change the gain on channel number 1, because this is the preamp gain, this is not a digital trim. Okay, so make sure that only the live mixing engineer sets the gain and you as the broadcasting engineer do not touch the gain. Okay, now channels 17 to 32 are still going to the main left and right. We don't want that, we don't want the channels to go twice to the main left and right, so I'm going to select each one of these individually and turn off the main stereo button. Next step is to go to bus number 11 and 12 because this is the furthest away from the live mixing engineer's site, so it doesn't get in the way. I'm gonna select bus number 11 and go to the home page and I'm gonna link it with bus number 12. Now this is a stereo pair, and while this is selected, I'm gonna go to the configuration page and say that it's a subgroup. Confirm. Now I'm gonna select sends on fader or the flip fader button. I'm gonna turn it on while this is selected and I'm gonna unmute channels 17 to 32. Now these channels are going to the subgroup and not to the main left and right anymore. And while this is still on, I also need to send two of the effects buses. So I'm gonna go here and unmute effects returns 4 and 3. These are the returns for these two. I'm gonna also select them and remove them from the main left and right. Good, and when you're done, make sure to turn this off. And before we go to the control app, we still have some things to do on the console, including routing the subgroup 11-12 to physical outputs and also putting a limiter on this subgroup because a broadcast mix needs a limiter.
Thanks, Captain Obvious.
I'm gonna go to the routing page again, and then I'll go to the right, to the out page. And by default, buses 11 and 12, this stereo subgroup, go out of outputs 11 and 12, which are the XLR outputs on the back of the console. And also by default, it is post fader, and I advise you to keep it post fader. Now you can also call them something different like TV left and TV right to make it easier to recognize this bus. and we still need to put a limiter. So I'm going to go to the effects, go to the effect number 5 and select the precision limiter, set it, and then I'm going to say that it's going to go on bus number 11 and bus number 12 and turn it on. Then I'm going to select the bus number 11 and 12 and go to the home page and make sure that the insert is post everything. So it's directly before or after the fader, because
technically, yes, the insert is before the fader. This is a diagram from the M32 manual, but it is not a part of the pre-fader signal. This is the pre-fader tap. It's right before the insert. Now, if you put the insert before the EQ and compression right here, yes, it will be a part of the pre-fader signal. But in our case, right now, we need it to be the last thing in the signal chain. So it is after the pre-fader tap, okay? The fader is the last thing that controls the output of the channel, but the insert is not included in the pre-fader signal. This is a bit technical, but I think it's a good idea to know these things.
Okay, great. Now, if the limiter is distorting, if it sounds like it's chopped up, you probably have the release time very quick. You need to slow down the release. And if it sounds muffled, like it's soft, you probably need to increase the attack time because it's grabbing onto the transients too fast. It's also a good idea to have the same effects on the effects buses for both the broadcasting mix and the live mix, just for consistency. And also very important, do not get into each other's mixes. Let the live mixing engineer do his thing and the broadcast mixing engineer do his thing. And you as the broadcast mixing engineer, do not change the input gain of the channels. That's very important. Leave that up to the live guy. Because if you change the input gain on your channel, this is not a digital trim, this is actually the preamp gain. So you will mess up the other mix. So to keep things more separated, you're gonna connect the mixer to the control app, whether it's on your PC or iPad or phone, it doesn't matter. If you don't know how to do this, click on this video right here. I made a video about it, then come back to this video. And I wanna tell you a very important thing, and it's to go to setup and then go to GUI preferences and see if these two are on. If these are on, turn them off, because right now, if I select something on the mixer, it will show up on my screen. And if I'm, let's say, EQing a channel right here for the broadcast mix and the live mixing engineer selects a channel, I'm now EQing that other channel and it will mess up the mix. Okay, so be sure to turn off selected channel follows mixer and selected screen follows mixer. Turn them both off. And now I'm gonna create a custom page and only have what I need on there. So I'm gonna select user one and then hit edit. And I'm gonna put on there channel 17 all the way up to 32. And I'm also gonna put the effects buses 3 and 4. These are the sends. And I'm also gonna put mix bus 11 and 12, which I call TV left and right. And I'm also gonna put effects returns 3 and 4. And this is everything I need on this page. Now close this. And if you wish to send a channel to an effect bus, you're gonna select the channel, then go to the sends and send it to 3 or 4. These are the buses for the broadcasting mix, the effects buses. Okay, and be sure to not touch any of this because this changes the configuration for the buses. Okay, so be aware of this. Now the monitoring situation gets a bit tricky because the outputs you're sending out of the console for the broadcast mix are not connected to speakers. They are going directly to whoever is responsible for broadcasting. But you still need to be able to hear the mix to be able to mix it, right?
You have two options. First option, if you have two extra outputs on the back of the console that you're not using, you can send this bus 1112, the broadcast mix, to a matrix. So I'm gonna select this bus and go to the matrix, hit flip fader and send it to matrix 1 and 2. And make sure to turn this off again and then link matrix 1 to matrix 2. So it's a stereo pair. And you can go to the routing page, to the out page and say that, for example, output 1 is gonna be matrix 1 and output 2 is gonna be matrix 2. And now this is the level that is going into your monitoring speakers.
So the level that is going into your monitoring speakers is controlled by the faders of matrix 1 and 2 and not bus 1112, because that is going to the broadcast mix.
You don't want to mess with that. Now, if you don't have these extra available outputs, you're going to go to option two, which is to use the monitor output on the back of the console or the headphone output in the front of the console. And here's how to set up the monitoring source so you can actually hear what's going on.
I will go to the monitor section, then click on view to set the monitor source. Now, I was hoping there would be an option to select a bus. Unfortunately, there is not. So by default, the monitor output will give you the main left and right. If there's nothing in solo, if there is something in solo, then you will hear the soloed channel or bus. But you don't want that because you're mixing broadcast. You want to hear bus 11 and 12. So I'm going to set the monitor source to off. Okay. And I'm going to solo 11 and 12. And now 11 and 12 are coming out of the monitor output. Okay. And if nothing is soloed, nothing is coming out of the monitor output. Now you want to make sure to keep this soloed and talk with the live mixing engineer so they do not press solo on anything to not interfere with your mix or your monitoring situation.
Now keep in mind, this console was neither designed nor intended to do this kind of stuff. So if you want to do this, you're going to have to accept the compromises that you're going to need to do and all this fiddling around. And if you don't want any of this, you can just send the main left right to a matrix and put a limiter on that matrix to make sure the signal is compressed enough and loud enough to send into broadcasting, and send this matrix out of two XLR outputs on the back of the console, and that would be it. Now, if you found this video helpful, consider hitting the like button. I would appreciate that very much. And here's the video that YouTube wants you to watch next, and here's the video that I want you to watch next. So click on one of these videos and I'll see you there.